Hello, Dunecrest America School teachers, and welcome to August. Yes, we are less than a month away from the first day of school, and let me tell you, I am so excited to have everybody back. It's going to be wonderful. We have seen many of you over the summer, and you're encouraged to still come on by school. I love seeing everybody, but we will be back in session very, very soon. So August is here. We also wanted to announce that all of our new teachers are now officially in Dubai. I picked up the last group last night, so we're all super excited about them being here. Please stop by and visit with our new teachers. They're all hanging out in their apartments there in Motor City, but they love having visitors, and I'd love for them to see you, and so please do that. We want to keep them busy and energized until we get them to school to orientation. Also, the school building itself is open. You're welcome to come by anytime. You do not have to call me anymore or text me to ask permission to come onto campus. We are at 100% capacity abilities now as of August the 1st, and so you're welcome to come by anytime that you like. However, if you do come by, a few things I want to make sure that you're aware of. One, you must be wearing your mask. And so make sure that that's on your face properly as you come into the building. Also, as you can only enter through the main lobby. Your temperature will be taken there in the lobby. And so you'll have to take care of doing that. Also, about half the rooms in the school building have already been set up for our regulations that we're required to do for KHDA and Dubai Health Authority. So if, as far as student desk is concerned and chairs, if you go into your room and it's set up, please do not move any furniture because they don't have time to be redoing stuff. So please make sure that you don't move any furniture anywhere in the building, okay? If your room hasn't been set up yet, more than likely this week it will be finished. So I'm working with Raj, who's back now, so we're excited about him being back too. And we're getting everything else finalized and set up to where we make sure that we meet the distance requirements by KHDA and Dubai Health Authority. So again, please do not move any furniture in the rooms. Alrighty. And just to talk a little bit about the rooms, some of our elementary teachers will be asking you to move rooms. I've gotten a hold of all of you, so you should know the folks that I'll be moving, and so we'll take care of that. If you're teaching in pre-K through grade 10, for core subjects for sure, and in some cases subjects outside the core also, these students are not allowed to move classes. So we as the teaching faculty will have to go to them. So I've set up specific rooms for pre-K through grade 10 that everybody will be going to for those classes in the all core areas and in some elective exploratory classes also. And so I'll be explaining that to you. Your principals will explain that to you once I explain it all to them. And so they'll be getting that to you. If you have any questions, you're welcome to call and ask me. I'm always excited to hear from you. And then for returning teachers, don't forget August the 24th is our first day back officially. I know many of you are already coming in, so we're setting things up and getting ready for that. And so we'll do that. Our motto this year is going to be smart, stay apart. So you will hear that quite a bit. And so we want to keep everybody safe and healthy. And so we're going to do that by being smart and staying apart. All right. So we need to do that. I want to go over a little bit about our Dunecrest American School reopening plan. This will also be attached to this email. I'm going to be releasing this information to our parents later tonight or early tomorrow morning. But I wanted the staff to have it first, so you can read through this, and just in case you get any questions, I know you get asked lots of questions also. Also, want to tell our new teachers, this email that you're receiving today, this will be the last email that I send to your personal email addresses. After today, I will only use your Dunecrest email address, okay? And so this podcast should be going to both your personal email addresses and your Dunecrest email address. So check your Dunecrest account. And if this came through, everything's perfect. If it didn't come through, let me know and I'll get one of our crack IT squad members to come and help you, okay? While you're being smart and staying apart. Alrighty, so to begin with the school reopening plan, the first thing we have is our mission statement and our pillars and belief statements. And so these are vital. And so I want you to, again, to read over those and make sure that this is what's driving what we do, because this is what's driving this reopening plan and everything else. I do want to talk a little bit about our pillar, perseverance, because we teach our kids to persevere when things are hard and to learn to turn challenges into opportunities. That is going to be a goal of this year, because it will be some challenges this year. There's no doubt about it. But we must always stay positive and teach our kids to look at the positive side of every situation. And so we want to do that. And so we will persevere through this. Now, getting into the plan a little bit, I highlighted some things I just wanted to talk to us about. Dunecrest American School is dedicated to reopening our campus the safest way possible, because we believe doing so is in the best interest of our students. And what this is getting at is our plan that we turned into KHDA, we wanted our school to be open. We have limited the size of the school to 450 students. Our building is designed for 1,200. And so obviously we can do this relatively easy and give us the space that we need to physically distance. We don't socially distance here at Dunecrest. We physically distance each other. And so this gives us the optimal space to do this in, okay? Now, there has been multiple versions of requirements from KHDA and the Dubai Health Authority both. And so we have continually updated this plan over the summer as we've gotten new regulations. Even as of this morning, I got some new things that was sent out. And so that has also been addressed. But our goal, as we talk to folks, is we want everybody in school on the campus. We feel like this is the best way for them to learn and for us to have a positive school experience. Dunecrest American School must, however, be able to respond quickly to the challenges in our school community, as well as to the conditions in Dubai. And that means is we have to be flexible. We have to be perseverant. When things have to change, we have to change. And we need to be positive about that and find ways to make things work, okay? If conditions demand that we need to close our campus, then we will continue to support students through our distance learning program. The reason why I highlighted this, and yes, we want to be open and moving forward in a face-to-face manner. However, I will tell you folks, just by the stuff that we read, by the stuff that we're seeing happening, the conversations that I'm in with our leaders here in Dubai, it's obvious there's anxiety. My gut feeling tells me that sometime during this school year, we probably will experience another online opportunity to teach our kids. So knowing this, going in from day one, when you're developing your lesson plans over the next month and getting ready for the first day of school and the first week of school and the first month of school, we need to make sure that we're teaching the kids how we would teach in an online environment. Again, this is one of the things that we did very well last year, and we want to continue that this year if that so happens to us. So make sure that we're embedding into our lessons these opportunities. Make sure the kids understand well how to use Seesaw. Make sure the kids understand well how to use Google Classroom. Make sure the students understand well how to use OneNote. Whatever it is that we're using in our classes, make sure that's embedded from day one, to where if we do have to go to an online learning situation, it's a seamless process for us and we just move straight to it, okay? All members of our school community must value and care for others. This must be a commitment we make, that we're taking care of each other during this time, okay? During the COVID-19 pandemic, this means complying with rules and policies designed to keep our school's community safe and healthy. This means thinking of others, appreciating that their risk tolerance might be lower than yours. So in other words, we just don't pop into somebody else's classroom just because we want to pop in and say hi to them. You need to make sure that you understand that you're welcome. We will come up with ways that we are sending signals to each other throughout the day, but we need to make sure that we're respecting those who need to feel like they need a little bit more isolation than others. That's perfectly acceptable, okay? And we need to make sure that we honor that. We have some of our teaching staff that medically are a little bit different than other staff members medically. And so we need to, again, be mindful and be respectful of these people and making sure that we're honoring them as we progress through the year. This means thinking of others, appreciating that their risk tolerance might be lower than yours, and adjusting your behavior with sensitivity and respect will be needed, okay? This means respecting the policies and expectation, even when it is inconvenient to you to do so. So let me give you some examples. I love shaking hands with people. This is the way that I greet people. This is the way that I think encourages folks to communicate with each other. Plus, I think it teaches them the way the business world and the real world sometimes works. This is how you typically greet people. I have had to adjust this myself. I don't shake hands with folks like I used to, just like always. And matter of fact, I discourage it rather than do anything, because we have to keep each other safe. That has to be our priority first. I know a lot of us like to do fist bumps or whatever as kids are coming, or give hugs and things like that as kids coming into your classroom. We just can't do that, folks. And I know that's going to be hard for us to think about, but let's use the fist bump as an example, because everybody's like, oh my goodness, why can't we do a fist bump? Well, you as the teacher, you have to remember, you've got, you know, 20-something kids that's coming into your room, and sometimes they come in multiple times. Every time that you're doing fist bump, you're passing along germs to kids from the first kid all the way to the last one, okay? And we're trying to teach folks that we need to be smart and stay apart. That includes things like this. Can we get creative with exciting ways how to greet each other and to bring excitement? Yes, that's what we need to do. And we'll discuss those ideas with each other and we'll examine those. But physically, we need to be apart to keep everyone safe, okay? And so we've got to come up with ways to do this. This is going to be inconvenient because it will make us change the way we do things. But that's what we need to do now to keep each other safe. I'm going to let you read the rest of this, most of this on your own. And so I'm just going to hit the stuff that I just want to make sure that we see. Next thing is, the normal school operation will not be possible, nor should it be possible for Dean Grace American School for the foreseeable future. Safety and well-being must take the priority for all of us. And so I gave you one example just now that we talked about, and this will continue. And it's important that we remember this, is yes, school's important, but the safety and well-being of everybody right now must take the lead in everything that we do, okay? The driver of our staff bus will take temperatures of staff members as they enter the bus. And so when you're getting onto a school bus, the driver will take it. If your temperature is above 37.5, you will be asked to leave the area and go back to your apartment and call your principal about setting in sub plans, okay? So let's make sure that we do that, and we should not be coming to school if we're sick. For everyone, upon entering the building in the main lobby, all students, staff, parents, and visitors will have their temperature taken through a thermal camera and will only be allowed to leave the lobby if the temperature meets the requirement of 37.5 degrees, okay? So this, again, is something we'll need to to follow. At arrival time or any time during the school day, if a student's temperature, teachers, is above 37.5, or, this is especially important, teachers, if they show COVID-19 symptoms, they need to be immediately taken to the school clinic, and parents will be called to pick up their child. This is something we have to keep an eye on all day long to make sure, again, that we're keeping folks protected. I will have the doctors and nurses going around the building periodically just to do random temperature checks in classrooms. This is stuff that will just be implemented into our day. But you as the teacher are sort of front line. And if you see someone that has got bad signs, don't make a call yourself. Send the kid to the clinic. We're going to be very, very conservative on this. If it looks like someone's got some signs that we're concerned about, we probably will send them home, okay? And that's okay, but we want to make sure that we keep the masses safe and that to keeping everyone as risk-free as possible, okay? Parent meetings and faculty meetings. All external parent meetings and after-school faculty meetings will be held through Zoom, because we shouldn't be meeting with groups above six. We have no groups that's really lower than six. Now, that doesn't mean that we won't call you together in small groups or things like that, but faculty meetings and parent meetings primarily will all be handled through Zoom, okay? And we'll let you again read just stuff that's in our plan here, especially classroom materials, but did want to put you on to this. Hand washing many times daily with soap and water is critical. And so I'm going to ask every teacher in the building to come up with a way. What are you going to be doing to make sure that your kids are washing their hands with soap and water? And again, we want to wash the germs away. Just using hand sanitizer is not good enough, okay? We need to come up with ways to wash the germs away, okay? And so every grade level, including the secondary school, remember this, just because the kids are bigger does not mean that they're really into wanting to wash their hands constantly, okay? We have to come up with plans to make sure that every class the kid is doing this. And so we're going to be coming up with some criteria for the middle school and the high school, and the same thing with elementary, on what times a day that we're going to expect people to be washing their hands. And you'll have to build this into your classes, okay? Again, we want to keep everyone safe. Physical distancing, just so you know, the school will place stickers on the floor to help ensure a 2 meter distance is maintained. And just because we have stickers on the floor doesn't mean they're going to be followed. This takes all of us talking to kids that aren't following the 2 meter distance to make sure that they do this, okay? So that's pre-K all the way to grade 12. If a student's not following the 2 meter distance, we all take ownership and all of us say something to the students that do that, all righty? And classrooms will be limited to students assigned to the classroom and that instructor. So in other words, we will not have students coming into classrooms that they don't belong to, okay? So we can't have visitors, is basically what this is saying. The classroom space is specifically designed for the kids that's in that classroom. Also, classroom areas will be arranged so a distance of 1.5 meters will be between each student. So again, your classes are being set up. That's how I'm getting so buff. I'm moving lots of chairs and chairs and desk around. And so make sure that we do not move student furniture inside a classroom, okay? Special events, all of our festivals, holiday events, special performances, school trips, camps, and sports tournaments at this point are canceled until further notice. However, I do want us to come up with creative ways that we can still perform. I mean, we still have drama productions and we still have, you know, singing going on and band playing. And so we have to come up with ways on how we're going to promote these kids and to making sure that they get seen performing. And so we want to do that. We'll probably do this virtually. We'll be doing a lot of recordings and send those recordings out. And then we'll find some live ways to do that so we can live stream some performances too. Food and beverages, the dining hall will be limited to 50% seating capacity. This has already been done. So the dining hall is set up on how we can use it. And the seats are where they need to be. There'll be stickers on the tables of places they cannot sit, okay? When a student comes into the dining hall, they may take their mask off, and the mask needs to go into a plastic bag that they'll bring with them. And so they'll do that while they're in the cafeteria. We will have prepackaged food sold in the dining hall. It'll be prepared there fresh every day. It just has to be prepackaged for them or for you as a staff member to enjoy. Finally, in conclusion, I want us to sort of read this together. We need all members of our community to accept new responsibilities within this changed environment we will experience over the next year. Acting with self-awareness and sensitivity to others will be key. In other words, we have to keep other folks in mind. You know, I'll use me as an example. I have a very high tolerance rate. I still go to restaurants to eat. I still in trying to enjoy life as much as I can. I know people, though, that since March have not left their house. And so I have to be sensitive when they come in. They're going to be scared. They're going to be worried about things. And we have to be careful about that, okay? And we have to respect their opinions and their rights, okay? We must learn to recognize that change will be embraced and supported with enthusiasm. And I promise you, folks, things will change. That's one thing I've learned this summer, working with KHDA and Dubai Health Authority, is about once a week, everything changes. These reports, as you've seen here, they're not easy to write. This is about the ninth version that I've put together. And I have learned that I have to be positive about it. The greater good of everyone is what's at stake here. And so we need to be positive even when changes are given to us. And we need to enthusiastically embrace those changes. All right, be positive about it. When our students express frustration with rules that limit their social interactions, you can express your understanding, but discourage their cynicism and remind them that the measures are in place to keep everyone safe, including them. Okay, I've had lots of talks with students over this summer, and you know, part of I think their frustration is, you know, they don't see this as big of a deal as maybe the rest of the world does, and so we have to get them to understand that they have to remember different students and different adults and different people have different anxiety levels of where things can happen, and so we want to make sure that we're respecting those differences. Okay. And so make sure that when you cough or have a fever or just not feeling well, you need to stay at home. It's the bottom line, okay? And kids need to stay at home too. If you see someone sick, you need to send them to the nurse's station, okay? If you know of another workplace that has an innovative way to address safety, please share them, all right? A collective and unified school community effort has never been more important as it is today. And so all ideas are welcome. Just because we have an idea doesn't necessarily mean we can implement it, because it might go against something else that we're doing. But listen, all ideas are great ideas, and please share those. I've enjoyed the ideas that I've already received this summer from many staff. And so these we want to continue. Remember, we talked about 2 years ago, talked about again a year ago, and I'm going to talk about it again right now. I want you to take ownership of Duncrest. This is not my school. This is our school. And so it's important that you take ownership. And if you see stuff that can be done better, let's discuss it and let's see if we can make it happen. All righty. That's what we want to do. We are the Duncrest Eagles. Go Eagles. And we will soar to new heights with new ideas and new innovative ways of doing things. We will find a positive way to reopen school and continue our journey of educational excellence. Teachers, I'm excited about you coming back soon. I can't wait to see you back on campus. And until you're back here, have a restful rest of your August.